from National University of Singapore, and she will talk about Panoply, low TCP Linux applications with SGX enclaves.
Good evening, everyone. Can you hear me? I'm Shweta, and today I'll be presenting our work, Panoply. So today, if you want to run a web server, you end up trusting thousands of lines of hypervisor code on top of billions of lines of operating system code just to run a few thousand lines of web server logic. Certainly, this has a large TCB. What a large TCB does is it increases the probability of vulnerabilities. More importantly, it also makes difficult to give any guarantees about the web server logic in the presence of untrusted operating system and an untrusted hypervisor. With the recent advantages in trusted computing, what we have is technologies such as Intel SGX, which allows us to create abstractions called enclaves. With enclaves, what the hardware allows you to do is run small pieces of logic inside enclaves, and the hardware ensures that all the other untrusted entities, such as an operating system or parallel applications, cannot access enclave's memory called the enclave page cache. So going back to our web server example, if we use SGX, we can just port the web server logic inside an enclave and do away with trusting the operating system and the hypervisor. So we can say that our web server will have confidentiality and integrity guarantees. So problem solved. SGX eliminates all the non-application TCB. Really? The catch is that SGX limits the amount of expressiveness that your applications can have. For example, it does not allow your enclaves to do system calls. So how are you going to run a web server? Well, people have looked at this problem, and there has been a line of work called library OACs, which allows you to do system calls and all the other operating system operations, such as threading and forking. What they do is that they import a lot of operating system logic inside Ring 3. So one of the examples is Haven, which allows you to run web servers in cloud. The drawback is that it incurs millions of lines of TCB, taking us back to the problem. There has been other approaches, such as containers, which allow you to run Dockers inside enclaves. Dockers allows you to run web servers, but they do not allow you to have expressive code such as forking. So in this design space, does there exist a solution where you can achieve maximum expressiveness while keeping a low TCB? And this is the question that we're trying to answer. We present Panoply, which achieves a lot of expressiveness. In fact, we end up supporting all the POSIX APIs while keeping the TCB minimum as low as two orders of magnitude lesser than library OACs. And as a cherry on the cake, we also allow fine-grained TCB reductions by isolating libraries of an application in multiple enclaves. We achieve this while keeping the performance close to library operating systems. So why has this been a hard problem? Let's take a running example of a web server. Let's say you want to run this inside an enclave. The first and foremost thing you're going to do is port your web server logic inside the enclave. That should be the start. But as I said, you cannot have any system calls. So then you have to emulate system calls inside an enclave. Well, then you will also have to have threads to support runtime requests for the web server. Just add the thread handling logic inside the enclave. Well, you'll also have to poll for network requests, so you add event management logic inside the enclave. In the end, if you want to do runtime load balancing, you need to fork your web server. Okay, just add the fork emulation inside the enclave. And now you see the point why the TCB of an enclave keeps on increasing as you want more expressive logic inside an enclave. So the equation we are really now narrowing down here is that the more the expressiveness, the more is the TCB. And this is exactly opposite to the problem statement that we are trying to solve. Okay. The second challenge is that you may want to run your whole application inside a single enclave, But you might end up with a bug like Cloud Bleed in your web server, which in turn will compromise all the other libraries that you're running inside an enclave, such as a SSL library, which might leak your private keys. So today, developers are encouraged to separate their libraries into different compartments, and SGX naturally fits this design. You can run your web server in a separate enclave and your SSL library in a separate enclave. So any bug in your server logic will not be able to access your private keys in the SSL library because the hardware does not allow you to do so. However, how do these two enclaves talk with each other? They talk via the operating system, and this opens a new channel of attacks via the operating system communication channel. Let me show you a simple example of how these attacks look like. Let's take this piece of code from a web server. What it does, it sets up a callback for the SSL library and then starts executing the initialization phase for the SSL session. Our web server sends this request to the SSL enclave via the OS. Now it's up to the OS whether to relay this request to the SSL enclave or not. A normal OS will do this. However, a malicious OS may silently drop this call. And because the server logic has not accounted for these kind of attacks, it will just continue with this SSL session setup without validating the certificate. There are other subtle attacks of these, apart from dropping, which include spoofing attacks and also replaying the attacks which the enclave never requested. So these are the two challenges that we will be addressing in Panoply. So how does Panoply address this? What we create is called a microcontainer, or micron. A micron runs inside an enclave, and it comprises of the original enclave logic. And it also has added Panoply shim libraries to achieve expressiveness and to protect against the attacks. And it also has some basic libraries for remote attestation, which we take from SGX. All the rest of the code, such as the libc implementation, the operating system implementation, the non-enclave logic, and untrusted libraries, are always outside the micron. And this is how we reduce the TCB. Well, this is not the design principle, but the technique how we reduce the TCB. If you want to use Panoply in your existing applications, you have to give the source code and also annotations for specifying which libraries run in which enclave. Out comes a Panoply application which contains of multiple microns interacting with each other. Internally, we instrument the code to add calls to the Panoply API, such as system calls have to be redirected to Panoply API, and we also need to add checks to defend against the operating system attacks. After we have this, we just compile it down to executable enclave binaries, which have been signed and linked with Panoply shim. So as I was saying, Panoply supports expressiveness for applications. So how do we actually do this? The guiding principle that we use to reduce the TCB is always delegate rather than emulating the logic inside an enclave. So this is how we do it for each of these expressive APIs. Let me take one example to walk you through the design. So as I was saying, there are many POSIX APIs that we support. So let's take an example of fork. So the original fork semantics says that when a parent process invokes a fork call, the operating system should create a new child process, assign a new PID to it, and should also ensure that the child process can access the parent's pages. Traditionally, for doing this inside the enclave, library OSs, what they do is they migrate all of the page copy logic and the PID management logic inside the enclave, which ends up bloating the TCB. So how do we do this without emulation and with delegation? So the way we do it in Panoply is that whenever the parent enclave requests for a fork, the enclave's request is just redirected to the operating system. The operating system's PID management logic spawns a new process and initializes a new child enclave. As you may have observed, the operating system cannot access enclave's memory, hence the child's enclave state is empty. So this is how it looks, how the state looks when the child state is empty. Its stack, heap, and the data section are uninitialized. What we do is mirror the parent's enclave memory state in the child's enclave. We first read, the parent enclave first reads all its stack, heap, and data memory and seals it. And then the child unseals this data and sets up its stack, heap, and data sections to resume execution. Well, this was one way to do it, where we do a full replica of all the pages. And as you may have guessed, it's very slow and inefficient. All the modern Linux operating systems, what they do is copy on write. We can achieve a similar notion in SGX, which we call copy on demand. And this requires a page for, handling the page faults support inside an enclave, which we expect to be released in SGX version 2. Another way to achieve this is doing a need-based copy. This involves statically analyzing the program and checking which are the addresses that the child will need access to. Let's take another example of achieving expressiveness. One drawback of SGX is that when you want to run threads, you have to statically specify how many threads, the maximum number of threads that your application wants to spawn before launching the enclave. In this case, the enclave specifies that it only wants 3 threads. What happens if, on demand, you want to increase the number of threads, as you may imagine in the case of a web server, to handle more requests? The current SGX systems does not allow you to do this. In Panoply, we introduce a notion of virtual threads, where the enclave can spawn as many threads as it wants at runtime. Internally, we monitor this number, and when this number increases, we spawn new enclaves for serving these requests. There is also a challenge of synchronizing states across these enclaves, for which we introduce a thread control manager. Moving on to the next challenge of attacks between enclaves. So these are the classes of attacks: spoofing, replay, and silent drops. For each of these, we introduce a notion to give a security property. For the first attack, we introduce the notion of enclave identity. Whenever two or more enclaves want to talk to each other, they first have to exchange their identity. Apart from that, we also have a pairwise nonce to stop replay attacks and ensure freshness guarantees. And finally, we do not proceed until we receive an acknowledgement for any inter-enclave call. And by this way, we can detect silent drops. So how does Panoply perform for all of these expressiveness guarantees? Seems like a lot of work. To evaluate our system, we chose 4 real-world applications which can benefit from SGX. And we also stress-tested our system with LMBench and measured the throughputs for various system calls and APIs. So the first is the TCB evaluation. Panoply has about 20,000 lines of code. Half of which is boilerplate code generated to support system call handling. As compared to library OSCs, which is millions of lines of code, we achieve 2 orders of magnitude reduction. In terms of performance, when we ran Panoply applications, we noticed that maximum amount of time is spent in just creating and taking down the enclave. Apart from that, a large amount of time is also spent in switching the context from enclave to non-enclave mode and encrypting and decrypting all the memory content that is passed across the enclaves, which is via O calls. So as you may see, for CPU-bound applications, the overhead is less, whereas when the application is I/O-bound, we observe a higher overhead. This is because every time you make an O call, and depending on the size of the memory that you're passing across, the amount of time that the CPU takes to do encryption and decryption increases. So let's see how does Panoply scale when serving different sizes of requests for a web server. So what we did was we increased the size of the web request that we were serving, and we measured the throughput for each of these configurations. A very interesting observation was that as we kept on increasing the size of the web request, we observed that the amount of difference in the throughput increased. So one takeaway from this is that If you want to have larger sizes of requests, probably you should use optimizations. We also compared Panoply with library OSCs. The red line shows the baseline through baseline latencies for I/O operations, and the blue and the green line show Panoply and Graphene SGX performance. We observed that both the systems perform comparably. Statistically, they vary by 5 to 10%. So in conclusion, Panoply is a new system for running enclave applications with high expressiveness and low TCB. And we've also opened up our benchmarks and case studies. In case you're interested to take a look, please visit our website. Thank you, and I'm ready to take questions.